there is very fundamental questions of the wave energy and the effects of the waves on the ice and vice versa. So by realistically modeling this situation, we're trying to set up a scenario where we can answer those questions. If you have really large waves and really weak ice, how much more are the waves going to cause a retreat of the ice than under milder conditions, for example?
A lot of the obstacles that we've been overcoming have been having to do with scientific questions about how these different models could couple together. So for example, the wave model is on a grid-based system, but ice can be irregular and come in different kinds of shapes. And so we have to figure out a way for those two systems to interact with each other in a physically realistic way, which is partially a computer science question because we have to implement the software to do this sort of thing, but it's also partially a scientific question. And so that's a lot of the basic research that we've been doing.
In our case, we're looking very small scale with our project at the interactions between individual waves and individual pieces of ice in the marginal ice zone along the edge of the ice pack. So individual ice flows are interacting with individual waves in our model.
And so what a lot of the work that I've been doing after the development of this model has just been validating our ice and tuning some of the parameters that we use to try and make our ice as realistic as possible and to match up with the data sets that have been collected in these laboratories.
The idea would be playing a role in ensuring safer naval missions in the marginal ice zone environment, because some of the ice flows that we're talking about, you know, while the smaller ones like the pancakes can be on the order of just a few meters in terms of their size, their diameter, larger ice flows can extend up to hundreds of meters and be quite heavy obstacles that can impede the path of a ship, especially when they begin to raft on top of one another. And particularly under stormy conditions, they can act as fairly dangerous projectiles that could damage ships. We're sort of trying to anticipate what's coming in the future. If the ice is going to be melting more in the future, then and the way there's going to be larger areas of open water, then you're going to have larger waves, then what's going to happen overall in the Arctic? Are we going to be ice-free in the Arctic sooner than we would think because of all this additional wave action, for example?